In today's video, we answer the question, how long do furloughs last? Hi everyone, Carl Valeri with Aviation Careers Podcast, and in today's video, we're going to answer the question, how long do furloughs last? Well, this comes in from somebody who's viewed a video, and don't forget to subscribe below and click on the bell if you want to be notified for more of these videos. And one of the things that a lot of people have as far as a question, and I'm glad you asked, is how long do typical furloughs last? Well, the answer to that question is, well, it depends. And I've seen furloughs go from zero to a lifetime. So that's not a really good answer for you. But on average, first of all, you got to understand as far as a furlough is concerned, a furlough is a leave of absence. In the aviation industry, it's usually a leave of absence that is non-voluntary. There are involuntary and voluntary leaves of absence. The way that furloughs are typically depicted in your union contracts at an airline, or they'll discuss the things that they'll do to mitigate furloughs. Those are company-offered leaves of absence. They're a lot of times called COLAs. There are also, you know, incentive lines, lines where you're flying less, and this really saves the company a lot of money. So going back to the original question, how long does a typical furlough last? Well, first of all, usually not going to see a furlough unless it's going to be at least for 6 months. And why is that? Because it costs the company too much money to bring you back and retrain you after a furlough. So best to let you go on typically a short leave of absence or an incentive line. So you're usually not going to see a furlough that's going to last less than 6 months. Also, as far as the length of the furlough, usually you're not going to see them go more than 5 to 10 years on a furlough. I know that seems like a really long time, and it is. But to put things in perspective, I've seen certain companies who've never furloughed, zero. And I've seen companies who've furloughed and have had furloughees on that list for over 10 years. And remember, there's usually furloughs happening at some point somewhere in the industry. And furloughs can happen because of a global economic crisis like we're going through now, or it could be specific to the airline that's having certain issues with their finances, et cetera. So it really depends. Now, one of the things you have to remember during a furlough is a lot of things can happen. While you're on furlough, another thing that can happen is you can get laid off. In other words, they can shut the company down and you can actually no longer have a job. Typically doesn't happen unless the company goes out of business, but that can happen. You can actually be laid off during that process. It's happened with a few airlines. Well, they were furloughed, and then during that process of furlough, that company went out of business. So we've seen furloughs happen, and in between the time of 2001 and 2013, we didn't see a zero furlough rate. We've seen furloughs during that whole period. It could be a period of where we also had multiple furloughs. We've seen that in the past. Someone's been furloughed, they came back from furlough, and then were furloughed again when the economy went south again. So a lot of the industry is very dependent upon the economy and also getting people out there to fly. So people don't fly for many reasons. It's financial, and also they might be afraid to fly. 9/11, look at SARS, look at what's happening now with COVID-19. So typical furlough is going to be anywhere from 6 months and longer. We've seen furloughs go 6 months, 2 years, 3 years. But one general rule of thumb, if somebody says they're going to furlough you probably for 6 months to a year, double that time. It's probably going to be about double that because of the fact that a lot of times they really don't know what's going to happen. For the current crisis, COVID-19, until we see a turn, we get some kind of vaccine for this virus, and also see people wanting to return to fly, this is the way things are going to be. It's going to be a little bit tough. During the furlough, a really important thing is to keep flying and keep yourself as much as you can in the cockpit, both in your mind and also physically flying. A lot of times we lose our skills. So how long do furloughs last? It really depends. It's usually going to be a minimum of about 6 months. Again, that's because of the cost of training for the airline in going through the recurrent, et cetera. And as far as the longest furloughs, they've been many, many years. As a matter of fact, they've been forever in certain cases where the companies have actually gone out of business. Well, I hope that's answered your question as far as how long furloughs can be. It really does depend. If you have any other questions, please go below in the comments and ask us a question. You also can do that feedback at aviationcareerspodcast.com. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell. There's going to be more videos like this, and also some videos that we do for the Stuck Mike Avcast as far as, you know, general aviation type of things, and some educational videos. Oh, and we do have a free video out there about how to put together your resume in 5 simple steps. So go check that out and subscribe below. This has been Carl Valeri with the Aviation Careers Podcast. And safe flying out there. And don't forget to do something today to move forward in your career.